show you exactly how that happens, how we have done it for other people before. I have an account in CallFire where we can actually, I took permission from some of my clients to show call examples that are live, going in the last few weeks. So I think that's pretty cool. And yeah, just wanted to show you that. But for the timing, well, are you the main, how do you say, like, do you go out to every single job, or do you have a small crew?
To look at the jobs, to meet the customers, I'm the person that goes. Once I get the job, then I have guys working.
Got it, got it. Okay, in that case, best would be for, to not start anything until you come back. Even though SEO usually does take some time for it to start kicking up, so it is actually, not a bad time to start a little bit before the main season comes, like March. But if you're not going to be here and you're not going to be able to like really see how I'm bringing the results every month, or if I'm bringing in results, you're not still going to be here. The only way it'll be possible if we were to proceed forward would be like at a lower budget until you come back, then we ramp things up. But as you said, it might be best for us to actually move forward with something once you get back. The other thing was, we don't work with anybody like in one area, like two people in one area, because it's counterproductive for us. Like it doesn't make sense for our network to build exposure in one area for two people. It's just like splitting the exposure. And the reason I'm saying that is because we wanted two clients, one from getting by January. So I was hoping to get that person before January 1st. But anyways, that's if you're leaving, that's pretty much where we can leave things at, and I guess we'll have to pick it up when you come back.
Yeah, we'll do that. Because if I'm not here and leads are coming in and I'm not taking advantage of the lead and I'm paying for the service and everything like that, it doesn't make sense it just doesn't make sense. I'm losing money. And somebody has to be here to take me home. So I'm pretty much a one-man show type of thing. I'm the one that meets the customers. I'm the one that answers the phone. I'm the one that everything, that does all the paperwork and everything like that. And then work gets done by my guys, but I'm the one that deals with the customers directly.
Yeah, that's what I was saying. Like, it wouldn't make sense to do the package, at least the one we were talking about. But would you be possibly open to even looking at what the other one is? Other, it's lower package. It's more like $1,500, but there's no leads coming in from the beginning. It's just SEO, and it's gonna take some time for it to ramp up. And I believe you need a new website, right? Right. See, honestly, this is not me just saying for sales. Like, it does take some time, especially with new websites. It could take, at least 3 to 4 months before things starts to go up. So if you were to go with a lower type package, obviously I would have to show you exactly what that would look like. Because like I said, it doesn't have leads coming in the beginning, but it has a step-by-step on Google Sheets live. You'd be able to see exactly what's happening for your business. And it has like live links. You'll be able to check like, okay, this is the new exposure, the press releases we got for the business, the new acquiring links, publishments, things like that we build on a weekly basis. And then that's what builds up the visibility until around, 3 to 4 months, it starts to really kind of ramp up and you start showing up in places, and then it goes on from there. That's how we normally used to do it all the time. It's just that it's a very, it gets to be risky for the business owner, and we saw there was a hole in the SEO industry where, like, contractors would be employing SEO agencies going in the red for like 5, 6 months, 1 year. That's when we developed the lead generation side of it, using AdWords and Thumbtack in conjunction with a few other stuff. But anyways, I just wanted to say, would you be willing to look at what it would look like if we were doing a smaller package where basically we build you a new website and then you'll be able to see what kind of work is being done for SEO, so then you still get a head start for March, April, that area by then, so we can have a pretty good standing with the website exposure and everything, because new websites will take time.
See, the thing is this, the package is just talking about 2 grand, 1500. job. So what I'm trying to say is that the budget that we're talking about, right, right now, $1,500 or $2,000, that's like $24,000 a year type of commitment is what we want. That, you know, is what you want from us, right?
Mm-hmm.
So I'm putting out $24,000, and I don't spend that type of money with HomeAdvisor, and they keep me busy throughout the whole year. So I'm just trying to weigh out my options. Does it make sense to me as a business? If one thing is working for me, do I have to go into, what's the reason for me to go into something else? This is what I've been thinking about for the past few days. If one thing is not working, like I tried Angie's List, right? It wasn't working for me. I stopped using it. I steered into HomeAdvisor, and the thing started working for me. You know, it started producing. The good thing about that is that you can shut it off whenever you want, turn it on whenever you want. You can raise your budget, lower your budget. You can figure out what tasks that you do, because I'm not only limited to one job, one type of task. So I can add tasks, I can remove tasks, I can do repair leads, I can do install leads. So in that sense, it's very the way the system works is pretty good. I'm not saying I can't handle more work, but what I'm trying to figure out is that why should I be doing this when something else is already working for me, and I have the option of shutting it off, and I'm not going to get charged in the meantime. So if I'm busy, if I have, like, let's say if I have 20 jobs, and I'm busy for the whole, and I have enough jobs for the whole month, right?
Mm-hmm.
If I'm working with you, I'm going to have to pay you $2,000, right? So that's why I'm trying to figure out, like, should I take that step or not? It's something I'm going to have to think about, of course.
Yeah, it's really, honestly, I could say a lot of stuff, but it's completely, it comes down to, you'd have to just think about it exactly, like, what your goals are with the business, because we tell people, like, when SEO starts working, a lot of people are like, should I turn HomeAdvisor off? We say, even to our clients now, when SEO is working, we say, no, you can keep it. Because HomeAdvisor works. It's one of the best services out there. Like, they're a billion-dollar company because of what they do. They will make your phone ring, period, right? And they give you flexibility and everything. But it's just that when you're looking to build an exposure that's directly with the consumers, like, you are right up there where they're searching, and maybe you can also direct your marketing. Like, after SEO works, for example, like for next year, the clients who are already up there, for my clients here, they're asking, like, what's our plan for next year now that we're already up there? So we're directing the energy towards, like, more installments, for example. Like, we're going to be optimizing for leaks, because those eventually turn into more installs. And sure.
Hello?
Hello?
Yeah, I'm sorry.
That's fine.
Okay.
We'll see. Oh, yeah, so as I was saying, you have a very, like I said, it's a very valid point. HomeAdvisor just works. It brings you a lot of leads, and they will make your phone pretty, build your business, you're not in a stage where you're just trying to get jobs, at least I think, because you already have a pretty good base. You have over 70 reviews, as you can see on HomeAdvisor. Usually what people like to do a lot of times is have a direct communication with their brand and the consumers, right? Which is the easiest place to do it is Google. After all, people don't go to HomeAdvisor directly to HomeAdvisor.com as much as people think. They go to Google, then they see HomeAdvisor's on top, then they would go there and fill out a form and wait for some people to call them back. Another thing is, it would come down to, like, in, for the future, how you would want to direct, actually, like, a business, to be honest. Like, for example, as I was telling you about my client, like, what they want to do now is we're working to creating a marketing, like a sort of a strategy where the roof installation in their area is perceived to be unique to their business. So, for example, like, there's a lot of moving parts to a roof installation. A lot of homeowners think that it's a commodity. Like, they think they can get an installation from this company or that company, and whoever's cheaper, more or less, they're getting the same thing. So we're working it out where when they're looking for installation, we make it sound like it's more than just the moving parts that are in there. So we might call it the company's system, and then we rank that as a separate page. And it's a whole different angle that comes into it, because then you're selling, and people who have reviews, they talk about the Earth system, and then, like, people people are lining up, you have a following, you know, people saving up when they get your system, maybe you have certain kind of financing, certain kind of, you know, maybe a little bit of a unique type of material you use somewhat that go together, maybe a different kind of warranty, whatever it is, you're able to direct your entire exposure in business in a way that is not as flexible with something like HomeAdvisor, because HomeAdvisor is the king of lead generation, but this is taking it in a way where you can actually be, you know, taking the way you want it. It's your own website, you own the platform, you own the listing that people are seeing, you own all the stuff that is bringing in the business. So that's really what I have to say in terms of SEO. You know, people do it because of what it brings to them and the control they have. It's actually part of the business. Like when you sell a business in the future, the listing is a part of it. Like you can sell your business more because, you know, you can say that, hey, my business is in the top. Like, you know, it's part of the business, not a service to the business. You're
yeah, but this just so you know, right? I don't think you know, but these service businesses, you really can't sell it.
Oh yeah, I know. I don't know anything about selling. I was just, you know, saying an example, like, you know, for listings in general, like other industries, for SEO, it's like you're investing in your, you know, your visibility, basically.
I understand, but let me put it to you like this.
Okay.
For example, a repair lead for a roof is about $16-$18 for repair, right? Okay, so we're doing a repair on a roof. Okay, we're doing an install. The install is gonna depending on if it's residential, commercial, anywhere from like $28 to $40 if it's an asphalt shingle roof, single ply roof, flat roof, depending on what it is. So roughly, let's say $25 or something like that. Okay. So if I wanted to get like, you know, I don't know if you guys guarantee any type of calls or not, whatever. But HomeAdvisor is a guaranteed thing. If I want to get 30 leads in. For let's say a repair, right? And it's $18 a lead or $60 a lead, right? That's like $500 somewhat, and I get 30 leads in. And a company like me that has experience, I think it's safe to say that I could close about 10 to 12 of them. So what I'm trying to get at is, you know, look at the investment that I'm investing with you, and look at the investment that I'm gonna have with this company. Let's see if I'm doing install or not, right? Which make us more money. Okay, we go with the install. And on the install, let's say it's on an average, even if it's $30, I'm saying, right?
Yeah.
Even if it's $30, that's like under $1,000, right? I want to get 30 leads coming in from that. You know? Most of the time we have a combination of some repair leads, some install leads or whatever. So, you know, $700-$800, you know, you're looking at, and you're getting a whole lot of leads coming in. And, you know, because they're coming in from HomeAdvisor, the customers look at the reviews. They even pick out certain contractors or roofers that they want to work with. They can choose a true contractor that they want them you know, to contact them. So what I'm trying to say is that I've been working with them for a very long time. I'm just having a hard time understanding why I should be doing business with you. This is my question to you. Why should I be doing business with your company when you're allocating a certain portion only to the AdWords part of it?
Mm-hmm.
And yes, I understand you're doing the SEO. I understand that. There's a set number, a budget for that also. But
yeah.
I'm just trying to grasp the understanding of why am I, you know, if I can already, if the thing is to, you know, is to generate a lead, right?
Mm-hmm.
And I'm able to do that already with the company. And I'm able to stop it, turn it on. I go on vacation for 3 months. I can turn it off in 3 months. I've worked with them for so long. They send me free leads also. They send me leads where other people can't close it. They throw leads to me for free. I'm just letting you know.
Got it.
They, you know, yeah, they do that all the time. Once a month, twice a month, they send me leads that other people were not able to pursue properly, or the customer didn't like them. They throw me leads, free leads also, and stuff like that.
Yeah.
So if you have a good answer for that, then I can think about this, and when I come back, I'll have an idea of what to be. Yeah, I understand this is more of like an individual thing where you're establishing, with exposure, you know, online exposure for my company on my own with the website and all that stuff. I understand that.
Yeah.
But if we're just talking about number-wise, and we're just talking about lead generation, and just talking about making money, you know, in specific, you know, specifically just that, then HomeAdvisor is working for me, right?
Yeah, true.
You know,
absolutely
I like
correct.
More business? Absolutely, why not? Can I get more So again, coming back to the same thing, how is it, how is me working with you or you doing whatever you're going to do for me more beneficial for my business than what home advisors do?
Got it. No, very valid point. Honestly, it just comes down to why any big company does SEO. Like if you look at other states and you look around just on searching, like companies, other companies who are doing massive amounts of business from HomeAdvisor, like 200, 300 reviews in New Jersey, things like that. Why do they also go for such a big budget in SEO? It's they're spending 3 times more money trying to show up for on top of Google, but then they're also doing HomeAdvisor. It comes down to really that, like I would say, like you're right now doing really well with leads, because I'm sure you're very good at closing. That's one. Your reviews are really good. You're just really good at what you do. So you know people come to you, and that's amazing. That's like it almost qualifies a lot of people to be really good in SEO as well. Because okay, let me cut it short. It comes like my answer would be like this. What would be your plan? Like let's say okay, 2018 goes even another great year, and you make your business like you double it, right? Are you looking to, let's say at some point, having somebody come in, like a project manager, who can actually go do what you're doing so you can strategize and maybe, grow it even more?
Absolutely. Why not?
Right.
Absolutely. If I have 3 vans right now, I would like to have 10 or more,
Okay, so.
Who would want that?
No, some people don't, to be honest. Some people, they're like, no, I'm really happy with how it's right now. I just want to maintain it. And that at that point where is when I would say like, hey, that's great. I there's nothing really we can do because HomeAdvisor will take you all the way. But since you do want to grow, like you said, from one truck to 10 trucks, if you look at just simple search volume, right? Like if I can even send you this, it's like public data, like from Google Keyword Planner, not like Yelp, not like, hey, there's 30,000 people searching for you. Like, not like saying, I'm not saying the whole state or anything like that. Literally right around Brooklyn, the current people who are up there, what kind of traffic they're getting, literally from data, from Google Keyword Planner, from SEMrush, they're getting about averaging about 80 to 110 people coming to the website on a regular basis. So that comes to around right over 3,000. And if you do the math, even if going by last year's standards, which was what like Google said, only 5 to 15% in the home improvement niche of the people that come to your website actually make a call to action, making like maybe a phone call, an email inquiry, maybe they fill out a callback form, whatever it is, 5%. Even with 5% of those kind of traffic, you're looking at around 180 to 200 people who are reaching out to you every single month asking for, hey, my roof is leaking, hey, I need this, I need to install, I need some kind of repair. So that's a significant amount of traffic, right? Now, that's when you're completely up there, you're at the top and everything, and everything's rolling really well. But it's something to think about, I would say. I think it does bring something to the table. Yes, it takes some time, but when it is up there and you own it, it's your own visibility, you can control it however you want. You can direct the traffic or not direct it. You can leave it in a certain place. You get a new service, you're like, okay, right now I want to do chimneys. Okay, I don't know if you're doing chimneys now, so a lot of people go like, all right, I want to start doing chimneys. Boom, we create another page, you're already an authority in Google's eyes, and within weeks, you start to get up there because your website and your presence is already authoritative compared to somebody who wants to.
So if I'm already doing the roofing and I want to go into chimneys, then I have to pay you more money?
No, we keep growing it out. That's the thing. I'm supposed to grow it out as you grow your business, basically. Unless,
but do I have to pay you more money?
No, you don't pay me more money. The only time the budget increases is when you actually want to go to a complete different area and also dominate there. And even then, I give a very big discount to current clients. But as long as whatever services you have, I say roofing is because it's the most profitable of all, or from my experience with my clients. It's first of all, it's the best thing to start with. But then when you're up there for that, we venture onto siding, to chimneys, and whatever services you bring, your authority is already established. That time, it's quite easy, to be honest, to bring and rank things because your website is already powerful in Google's eyes. A new website will have a very hard time coming close to competing with that kind of presence.
So how am I going to be able to be, how can I compete with, it's a Premier Roofing, you know, Fabulous Roofing, Fantastic Roofing, Green Roofing. These are companies that are old school Brooklyn, you know, big companies that do all this SEO stuff, right?
Mm-hmm.
I've been on the business way longer than I have been. How can I be competing with them? And how can you be guaranteeing me to come up there when there's all these companies that are spending tons of money with Google AdWords and up there? Like, I'm just, what it is to me is that even if I were to decide to do this, I'm competing with like the big sharks up there.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah, you
so
are.
I'm just trying to see that, yeah, how am I going to be getting money when they've been doing the SEO for way longer than me, right? For
yeah.
maybe over 15 years, right?
10, yeah.
15 years. And how am I going to be comparing to these guys? And how am I going to be, how much of exposure am I going to get? And, you know what I'm trying to say? I'm just
yeah,
trying
yeah.
to think about that. Because these guys are investing, these guys make tons of money, there's no doubt. They
yeah.
have tons of clientele, okay? They have referrals, of course. And then, of course, they get new business too. So the thing is that they're spending a lot of money with AdWords, you know, with Google. I don't know what companies they're using, like in terms of like search engines or whatever. I mean, not search engines, I'm talking about like SEO companies like yours, who they're using or whatever. But, you know, I'm just saying, like, how am I going to be competing with these companies? How can you guarantee that I could be competing with them in a good way, in a very good competitive way? I'm just not understanding how you're going to be able to achieve that. You have a lot of experience with the, you know, with the roofing, you're saying, okay, but how am I going to achieve that when there's big dogs out there
for
that
sure.
have been doing it for years and years?
Yeah, yeah, no, that's also very valid. You know, they have been out there for a while. The reason why I can, I have confidence in that is because I actually reverse engineer all the links that they currently have. So for example, like all the exposure they have built, which they have backing their website up, it's high up there. Like for example, the first, like let's say Fabulous and stuff like that is at a level, right? The people who are under them is some distance far, but it's not as far as you think. It's not like the finance industry where it's like they're just light years ahead and nobody could take care of them. The people who are up there right now, like Fabulous Roofing and stuff like that, their offline domination is very strong, but their online domination is also strong, but it's nowhere as it's not linear to their offline. If that makes sense, like it's very achievable. It's very with proper SEO and basically matching them. First of all, right in the first month, we match them for everything, all the links they currently have, and then we go on from there with all the strategy we have in the back. It's very achievable to get up there at the top. It's not like they are using, in other words, a very, very high technique or some kind of company which is super specialized in what they're doing. They just have a decent company that's doing what they're doing, and it's easily, not easily, but it's very achievable to take them over in a good way. I mean, if you want for me to show examples like of where our clients were, and who we took over before, like in other states, in Connecticut and New Jersey, we're talking about companies that's been around for 30 years. They started, the website was very aged, but we were still able to, you know, take over and go like that. And not to mention, when we would start, if we were to proceed, the first thing I would definitely do is try to find you a website that's already up there. For generic, like Brooklyn, like, you know, let's say roofing contract is Brooklyn, that's out there first, because we wouldn't go with a new website. Like, we would go with a website that's generically named, like, we would just own that. We would find a domain that's already indexed. Like, we wouldn't just go buy a new domain.
Wouldn't that be somebody's website?
I would buy that from them, I would acquire that. We'd do research and we'd acquire a website that's already indexed and aged. Because we research and we reach out, and that's how we do it. We also have brokers for roofing in the tri-state area. That's their main, you know, that's why I keep them, to find websites for clients who don't have, websites. And new website would put us a lot back. It still would be a little back, but nowhere near getting a brand new website. Brand new website, I would talk, you know, even more than a year before we can start seeing you up there. With a website like that, it would be a lot shorter. One of the main things I would say in terms of my expertise, I invest a lot in me knowing the latest techniques, and that's one of the reasons I believe where I'm able to have a little bit of advantage at least to rank websites much better than other people.
Like, it sounds exciting, I'm not gonna lie. It doesn't sound interesting, it sounds exciting. But
I
had bad experiences with these big companies. I told you, like, Yodel, you know, that's what that's the thing that they do the same thing you do.
Yeah, Yodel is they're really horrible though. Yodel is you know, there's many agencies that are
I experienced it, that's why I'm telling you what my experience was. It was horrible, and I just couldn't deal with these guys anymore. I had to stop doing business with them. But what do you call it? I actually just stepped into a store. I have to buy a gift for somebody. I'm gonna talk to you. Let's talk again tomorrow.
For sure. Is there anything you'd like? I can send you more info, videos about anything, like, you know, however you like it. If you don't like videos, I can send you some info about any of the stuff we talked about. Is there,
send me information about the companies that you're currently working
with. Okay, okay.
I want to look up those companies. I want to look at the stuff that you're doing. I want to call them.
You want to call some of my clients?
I want to ask them about you.
Okay.
And I want to see how those companies, what type of image those companies have.
Got
you
it.
Know, just out of curiosity, because I should be checking these things, right?
Yeah, for sure. For sure.
So send me some information on that, like companies that you work with. What about companies that, do you have anybody in Queens that you work with?
Queens, I have new roofing, but I'm not doing their SEO. We work with them a little bit. I just send them leads from here and there. Whenever we have a lead that's like out of my clients' areas, we get some of them sometime, I don't know how it comes, I just send it to them. So once or twice a month, he gets a lead from me, and I send them, because I know him from way before, like over a year and a half ago, when I was, when I was still doing the same thing. And I just know him for a long time before, and we'll keep in touch from time to time. So I just send him a lead from here and there, but you can still call him. I'm sure, you know, you could say something, but I could send you a few more clients who are currently working right now. So yeah, I'll send that to your email.
Okay.
All right, that sounds good. So thanks for your call, and I look forward to speaking more.
We'll talk again. Yes.
Take care. Bye.
Take care. Bye.
Jesus Christ, man. Talking about rebuttals.